began when the Human Genome Project that sequenced all the human DNA was completed in 2003. At first, it was a massive step forward to humanity. Enormous amounts of significant research discoveries were made. This shortly accumulated complex biological data related to how DNA encodes to proteins and how this process is regulated in human beings. The achievements of the project marked a new era in the history of biological sciences and had tons of technological applications. These sudden rapid advances in the scientific community weren't so easy to handle as you would expect. The information gained from this data needed to be quickly stored and organized to avoid any loss or mixing of this data. Of course, as a person, the 21st century, the fastest way to solve any of your problems is by the help of computers and the internet. Biologists have thought the same, and their problem shed the light on the importance and necessity of bioinformatics in the upcoming era, which is basically the field that introduced the application of data sciences to biology and made computer scientists and biologists unite to produce computational databases and analytical tools to evade this data crisis. One of the lead top fields of biology, which its research participated in the accumulation of information after the Human Genome Project, was immunology. You have probably heard about this field before. It's basically the study of the immune system and how it protects us all from foreign invaders. This system and its responses are networks of interactions between huge amounts of molecules, cellular receptors, and cells, which varies greatly between you, me, and any other person on the planet. It also varies according to the pathogen that infects you. For that reason, immunological data was one of the chief data in its diversity, complexity, and abundance. Hence, researchers had to specify a subfield of bioinformatics to immunology, immunoinformatics, which connects computational biology and immunology and will be our topic today. As mentioned before, the immune system is so diverse, it's divided into discrete types. The innate and the adaptive immune system promises many cellular strategies to combat pathogens by different immune responses. It also varies greatly between individuals, and honestly, it deserves a detailed video or even a whole video playlist on its own. But for now, we are discussing the necessity of its data managing. Immunoinformatic tools is mainly concerned with the functional, clinical, and epidemiological data of the system. According to the data under investigation, the immunoinformatic tools are subdivided into immunogenomic and immunoproteomic tools, which analyze genes and proteins related to immune function respectively. You probably still don't get the significance of immunoinformatics till now, but let me clarify it by giving you some examples for its applications. First, let's talk about epitope prediction and in silico vaccination. By using immunological databases, immunoinformatic tools can predict very specific unique parts on the surface of the invading pathogen that are capable alone of inducing a full immune response, which is called epitopes. These epitopes can be used to construct safe vaccines capable of inducing immunity like its live pathogen. The produced vaccine data can be then used for vaccination simulated experiments. These experiments are known in the scientific community as in silico experiments, and their success is an essential step in the vaccine development of modern times, which has to be done before any lab work. The processes of epitope prediction and in silico vaccination simply made vaccine development faster, safer, and even allowed for the production of vaccines that were impossible to produce before immunoinformatics. Another great application immunoinformatics offers us is the immune system modeling. Advanced immunoinformatics databases are able to offer a simulation for the complex interactions of the immune responses. Take the antibody-antigen interaction for example. Antibodies are key proteins of the immune system. Each antibody only interacts with its antigens. which are molecules with specific conformations that allow the binding of the antibody. This interaction depends on many factors like the nature of the antibody and the antigen and their surrounding environment. So having a live simulation in play in front of you will surely help you understand the interaction efficiently. We hope these two examples has helped you take a peek on what is going on in the world of immunoinformatics. It is really an interesting field that is rapidly growing these days. It is truly useful for you to know more about this field. If you're an undergrad, a grad student, or even someone who's just interested in biology, we will leave you some simple immunoinformatic tools in the description for you to try in your free time. There will also be our references and some further readings for you to check out there. Thank you for watching. We hope that you liked our first video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share it with your friends and family if you learned something new.